Morning, everybody.
Morning. Morning.
Lovely to see everybody. All the king and taking to the Lord. Everybody else at the court. We've got some more lining up outside, but I'll just read a few notices before they join us. First of all, we've had a letter from the circuit. We now have a Syrian refugee family living in one of the mansions that's not being used. They are very happy to be there, but their English is a smattering. But with the help of phone apps and things, they can interpret what they're saying. But they need help in getting around. They need help to get to the food bank and get to the other places that they need to go. If anybody will be able to do that, please re-contact either Martin Sykes or come to me. I've got two phone numbers that you can phone. It will be really, really helpful. So it'd be a case of people with a car who were able to ferry people about from time to time. It wouldn't be constant. Okay. There is a Christingle service at 4 o'clock next Saturday. Think about that. You're all invited, but especially the children. Christine was wondering if somebody would be willing to help with the Christingle, but also with some refreshments for people. So if they are, will you please see Christine after the service, please? We've had a lovely letter from the Salvation Army saying how thrilled we were. We sent 10 bin bags full of toys and things from the toy service and the cheque. And they are really, really thrilled and want us to know how many families will be happy this Christmas because their children will have Christmas presents. It's hard to think about, isn't it, that you could have a Christmas without Christmas presents, but we've helped a lot of families be able to do that. Please look in the foyer. There are baskets with Christmas cards in alphabetical boxes, so please look and just check and see if there are any for you. Before you go home. Obviously the next Sunday service will be Christmas Day. And finally, if we're nearly ready, I'd like to welcome everybody, because everybody is who's going to be in the service this morning. That includes you. We're all going to take part, hence my halo. And the young people are just getting ready, and they will be with us in a second. Okay.
It's Advent, not yet Christmas. It's not just time for you and me to prepare. It's time for all the world's different people to prepare. It's time to see God's message in all living, created things, the environment around us. It's time to make room in our lives for all ages and all genders, people who are overlooked, second-class citizens, ignored or put upon. Time to be grateful for Mary, who was one of these.
Let us think. Without Mary, young, pregnant and unmarried, where would we be? When God reigns,
there is room for all ages and genders.
Without that young woman who put her trust in God, what would we believe? When God reigns,
there is room for all ages and genders.
Without that commitment, that vision and faith, what faith could we have? When God reigns,
there is room for all ages and genders.
Without Mary saying yes to God and mothering Jesus, would the Saviour be ours? When God reigns,
there is room for all ages and genders.
Let us ask ourselves, if we scorn and shun because of age or gender, when God reigns,
there is room for all ages and genders.
We lit our first candle for you and me. We lit our second candle for people who are different from us. We lit our third candle for the environment and its care. Let us light our fourth candle for Mary and all who are marginalised because of age or gender.
Thank you. But you are. So some of you, if you haven't got a costume on, you can decide now whether you'd like to be a shepherd or a wise person. Okay. If you're a shepherd, can you join with me? Because the shepherd, now I'm originally from the West Country, so lots of farmers around here. Farmers and shepherds, similar idea. And in the West Country, farmers say, "Ooar." So I want you to put on your best West Country accent and say, "Ooar." So every time we say shepherds, you say,
"Ooar."
Excellent. And every time we say sheep, you say,
"Ooar."
Oh, it's like you've done this before. And when we get to the wise people, whenever the wise people come up, we all need to have a brainwave and say, "Eureka!" Oh, let's do it all together. One, two, three.
Eureka!
Oh, you're very good. You're very good. Right. So, have we forgotten anyone?
The sheep.
The sheep. Well, we're going to get on to the sheep in a minute. The baby. We've got a star as well. We'll come to that in a minute. So, we've thought about the people we need for our play. Before we get some props out, we're going to sing our first carol. So let's sing, let's stand and sing, "O Come, Ye Faithful."
Thank you.
The sheep. Has anyone seen any sheep this morning? Yes. So, it's your job now, you young people, because you're, you know, fit and limber, to go and find all of the sheep hidden around the church. Can you go and have a look for me? Go and find some sheep. How are we doing? Anything else? Any other props we need for our nativity? A manger. Has anyone seen a manger this morning? Excellent. Why don't we bring that out? Pop it. Oh, let's just leave it on the side for now. We'll get it in a minute. Oh, has anyone seen any of the gifts from the wise man? Got one there. Excellent. In fact, you can keep that one. Any other gifts? Oh. Do you want to go back there? Do you want to go back there? See if you can find one. And there should be another. Very good. So we've got the gift, we've got the sheep, the angels need a. Oh, the shepherds need a. The wise men need a.
Star.
We've actually got two stars. We've got one star here. Where's our other star? It's over there. I'm giving you a hint. Have a look on the floor. Have a look on the floor. Oh! I moved it. I moved it. We've got a star. What else do we need? If you look really carefully up there, see a very small shepherd's crook for a very small person. But none of the small people wanted to be a shepherd. So one of the big shepherds is going to have a very small shepherd's crook. Anyone tall enough to get our shepherd's crook down?
Stand on or just short.
No. Come here, Michael. Okay. Can we lift you up, Michael?
Oh, whoa, whoa.
Did you get it, Michael? Yay! So we've got our gold frankincense and myrrh. We've got our shepherd's crook. Oh, we haven't got our gold. Do you want to go and find the gold? You've got to be careful because it's precariously balanced. How about we could do with it? Can someone be able to grab us a chair for Mary? She's got a lot of hard work to do. She needs to sit in the chair. Right, so I think we've got all of our characters, we've got all of our props, we are almost ready to begin. We need some narration, don't we? Come and pop it on the stage. So let me introduce you to our six narrators. Just hold on. Come on, narrators. And before we begin today, I want to introduce you to someone special. Someone who is going to help to tell our story today. We've got two Marys today. We've got Mary, who's part of the story, and Mary, who's grown up, and she's come back to tell us what really happened all that time ago. Come on, Mary, you can join us. So, are we ready now? Are you all sitting comfortably? No? Yes, let's begin.
Come with us as we share with you this story, a special story, a wondrous story, a story that started over 2,000 years ago.
You look very good for over 2,000 years old, Mary.
Let's have our little Mary and our angel Gabriel come on the stage. That would be great. Our story starts not in David's city, Bethlehem, but in Nazareth, many miles to the north.
There I was, in the kitchen, minding my own business, washing the pots, and then, you're not going to believe this, but an angel appeared. There I was in the kitchen, minding my own business, washing the pots and daydreaming. Well, you're not going to believe this bit. But an angel appeared, and the angel said,
Do not be afraid. You will have a child, God's child, and you will call him Jesus.
Shall I tell you something? I've never been more afraid in my life. I'm so young, and I wasn't supposed to be pregnant. It wasn't very proper, you know? So I was actually very, very afraid. What would my parents think? What would Joseph think?
We're now going to think more of Mary's being told of her pregnancy by singing The Angel Gabriel from Heaven Came.
Come on, Joseph, take Mary by the hand, pop her on
on the donkey.
Wait, where's the donkey?
Ooh, me. Can I be the donkey?
You can't be the donkey. You're a narrator.
Well, now I'm a narrator donkey. Yes, I did have to travel on a donkey. 38 weeks pregnant. Can you believe it? It took us days and days. I could feel the baby kicking me all the way along. I think he quite enjoyed the donkey ride.
I expect they travelled slowly, not to harm the baby.
Oh yes, very slowly. Joseph was worried about me, so every time we got up to a decent speed, he'd slow us down again.
Go on then, have a little journey. We nearly had two adult Marys, so that would have been fun. Go on, Joseph, hatch up!
Look, they have just arrived at the inn. I wonder if there's any room.
Have you had a room in your inn? Only you and my wife. He's going to have a baby, you know.
Sorry, no room.
Isn't that awful?
Oh, they don't think it's very awful, do they?
No, it was worse than that. Would you want to be that pregnant with no bed to sleep on?
Oh, let's give her a big one.
Well, I suppose you could use the stable around the back, at least it is dry and warm.
So the only place Mary and Joseph could find was a stable, where they kept the animals. So there, in the little town of Bethlehem, the anxious, tired and exhausted couple waited under the stars for the baby to arrive.
Whilst we wait for the baby, Jesus, let's sing silent heavens.
On that first Christmas night, a baby was born in a poor stable to poor parents. The tiny baby was wrapped up and placed in a manger for his bed, and Mary looked at Joseph and said to him,
"Let's go in, Jesus."
You know, they always skip all the hard work I put in. Giving birth to a baby in a stable, no clean and sterile hospital, no midwife to hold my hand, no epidural or gas to help me through, just the cows mooing outside, having been kicked out for their resting place.
Wow, Mary, you're so brave. That all sounds so hard.
It was, but then I looked down at my baby's
face, and I knew it was all worth it. When I looked at his face, I had no idea what was in store for us next. No idea who he would become, the wonders he would do. But I held my little baby and knew he was special.
We're going to sing a song about that moment. It's not so much a carol, but a more modern Christmas song that we have sang previously at church, so you hopefully will know it. I've been told there's a very high note in it, so good luck with that.
I can play the whole verse through. Stop.
Shepherds. Thank you, shepherds. And I think we need some angels. Angel Gabriel, do you want to come back? Oh yeah, some sheep. Give the shepherd some sheep.
Can the angels say together, peace on earth, goodwill to man?
I think we can all do that, can't we? Because we've got two angels, so let's try that. Say it again for me, so we hear what we're saying.
Peace on earth, goodwill to men. All together.
Peace on earth, goodwill to men.
The angels sang their song to the shepherds.
Roar.
On the hillside, who were guarding their sheep from thieves and wild animals. And the sheep went.
Do not be afraid. I bring good news to you. To you, this day is born in the city of David, a saviour, Christ the Lord.
I wonder what the angel's song sounded like. Perhaps it sounded like the next song we're going to sing.
Let's all stand and sing, Shepherds Wake Up. And those who previously went to primary school can show us the actions.
To make the long journey to find out. But how did the wise men,
Eureka,
know where to go?
How did they know where to go? Follow the stars. Come on then, star. Come on then, you can take them on a very short journey.
Very short journey, come on.
We know a song about the wise men. Eureka, following the star. But in this song, we call them kings.
Shall we stand and sing, We Three Kings?
A threat to him. The wise men,
Eureka!
where Jesus was, and they brought him gifts. What were the gifts he gave? Can someone remind me?
Jesus, I bring you myrrh. The gift seemed very strange for a baby. I was thinking maybe some nappies or something for me, since I'd just given birth. But something struck me. As we sat there in that stable with our crying baby, tired and scared, he called him the King of Kings. He really must be special.
Unbeknownst to the new parents, Herod, who was a
nasty man,
was plotting to harm the baby Jesus. But an angel appeared again to Mary and Joseph and told them to escape to Egypt, and they stayed there until it was safe. So Mary and Joseph, with the tiny baby Jesus, left their country and fled to Egypt.
So that's where our story ends today. Some of us have heard that story so many times, so much that it feels normal. But it's anything but normal. It's filled with all sorts of unexpected people doing unexpected things. Smelly shepherds, who would have been the same as some of the lowest people in society, were the first to hear the news. Wise men travelling from afar, probably without a visa, to visit a baby in a stable. Mary, a woman, and a young woman, unmarried, was given the job of carrying the Son of God in her womb, to birth him and raise him, to send him out to do wondrous things. And then, a baby itself. God became flesh, and he didn't come as a powerful soldier or as a royalty born in a castle. He came to earth as a baby, born in a stable, no crib for his bed. Many of us know how fragile innocent babies are. There was no room in the inn that first Christmas night. But what this story tells us is that there is room for each and every one of us in God's story. No one is cast out. Everyone is welcome. Everyone can receive the love of God today. We're going to pray now.
Dear Lord, Mary's part in this story shows us your heart for all people. We thank you that there's room for us all. Sometimes we exclude people, tell them they're not good enough, or treat them differently because they don't fit in. Forgive us, God. Open our eyes and hearts, and make us more like you. God, we pray, for the young and for the old, may they know
there's room for all.
For the depressed and for the joyful, may they know
there's room for all.
For the hurt and for the healed, may they know
there's room for all.
For the bullied and the bully, may they know
there's room for all.
For the homeless and the landlord, may they know
there's room for all.
For us in here and those out there, may we all know
there's room for all.
Amen.
We've heard this morning the story of how Jesus was born and how, because he was so special, he was worshipped by shepherds, angels, and wise men.
Yeah.
Shall we give all our performers a round of applause?
O Little Town of Bethlehem. I'm going to take some photos during the carol, so if you would like to be in the photo that will go on our Facebook page, come and stand on the stage whilst we all sing O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Evermore.